Today we are going to do some street maths, but first let me tie my shoelaces.
I just realized that the shoelace style in both my shoes is very different. In one, there is a N zigzag pattern, while in the other, there is a crisscross pattern.
And so I wonder, do mathematics have a role to play in shoelacing as well? In how many types can you lace your shoe? And which of these will give you a better fit? Which is more comfortable? Do you have a mathematical idea? Burkhard Polster, a mathematician, has actually written a book on shoelacing, in which he is given a wide variety of shoelacing styles. Let's discuss some of these in this video. I'm going to discuss three most common styles which are used for lacing the shoes. Firstly, the crisscross lacing. The most widely used style of lacing is the crisscross style. We start from the top and push the lace in a crisscross manner. The zigzag end pattern. One end runs from bottom to top, while the other end zigzags through the remaining eyelets. This style comes as a factory setting, therefore it is seen in most of the shoe shops. This style was also commonly used in some military regiments long time back. Because if your foot gets injured, you can just swipe it off. Straight European lacing. In this style, the laces run straight across on the outside and diagonally on the inside. Although this is a visually messy style, but the zigzag on the underline makes it a very comfortable and holds the foot together, whereas the upper lining gives it a very neater look. You will be interested to know that if your boot has 6 pairs of eyelets, you can actually tie them in 43,200 different styles. How many of these have you tried till now? Go on. 1, 2, lace your shoe.